Hey everybody, welcome back. We're on episode 4 or volume 4 of our frugal tips for the week. So now this time it's a little different. I'm not going to talk about a couple of different items. We're going to talk about one item today, and that item is razors. I don't know about the men out there, but I know that you guys have a lot of electric ones that work phenomenally. Some of you like the old school blade on the face, getting that very thin to the skin look, which, by the way, does look very nice. And then the female razors, they're astronomical. I passed through the grocery store the other day and I saw them going for $20 for disposable razors. What are people thinking? This is insane. I'm not going to spend that kind of money. Now, I've been wanting to do this video for a very long time. I've put a lot of effort into doing some research, so you don't have to. Let's get started. First of all, we have two major companies that are running the competition these days on razors. We have the Dollar Shave Club razor, and we have the Harry's razor. So, what did I do? Well, of course I bought both subscriptions so I could see really what one is better and which one gives you the best value. Now, I will say I started with the Dollar Shave Club. It came in, I was very excited. It came with a couple of different things in the starter kit. It had a pump for a shave gel, and it also had inside of it like an aftershave that you can put on. And it came with some first starter razors. Now, particularly for myself, I have rheumatoid arthritis, so things feel a little different in my hands at times. However, I just did not really like the grip of this razor. It had a little bit of good weight, much better than the cheesy ones in the store, but I don't know. There was just something, I don't think it's distributed very evenly, I guess is what I'm getting at. So that was the first start to the Dollar Shave Club. So then I went to Harry's and I really appreciated their weight that they had in their razor. It felt much better in my hands. I felt like I had better control, especially when you're talking about going like behind your knees or something like that. Now they also gave me a starter pack with some stuff in it, and of course you get your blades. I think I had shave cream in mine as well. They both have different. Now Dollar Shave Club does a gel where Harry's does like a cream, and they both worked fine. I don't really have one or the other that I thought was better. I guess it's just kind of what you're used to using. And honestly, if you wash your hair and you got a lot of suds, you can use that as a barrier to help with shaving as well, just as a side note. So anyway, coming time to renew, and of course first I got the Dollar Shave Club. So they sent me, I ordered 2 extra packs, and when you sign up you have to buy into a membership. Now this membership is supposed to pay off over years, and it will help you with like shipping or anything extra you're going to get. And it was like 10 extra dollars per time, which equals out like $50. But I noticed when I went for my renewal, the prices were not the same. Now, one thing I noticed that you can do is you can extend it. So let's say your renewal is up next week, but you still have razors left. You can certainly push it out another month. So we had this, it says slice bread good, slice face bad. So these little boxes, and they come with your replacement razors in them. There is 4 in here. I was not very happy with the price though. That was a little shocking to me, and by far that was adding up. The other thing that I noticed was I had to replace the Dollar Shave Club razors very often. I felt like I was needing to replace them once a week, which that's really going to add up in price. So then it came time for me to renew with my Harry's. Now their pack's a little bit bigger, and It also comes with 4 razors. And just like the Dollar Shave Club, you can push out your renewal. I think I even tried doing it 2 months because I got 16 razors. You can go in and select the different ones you want, how many you want, and it will tell you a breakdown of how much they cost per razor. Of course, they have all the extra goodies. Both of them, you can buy shaving creams and blah, blah, blahs. Anyway, so this one was a little cheaper. Plus, I did not have to pay for the extra fee to get that beyond that membership to keep getting stuff in at a discounted price. Now, the one thing that I noticed with the Harry's is this razor lasted a really long time. I was 30 days in and still on my first razor, and that was shocking. I can't even get store-bought ones, much less paying for the dollar store ones. So, when it comes down to it, there was definitely some differences between the two. Now, if you hold them up side by side, they're pretty much the same. Now, if you will notice, with the Harry's razor, it has multiple different blades, and you can see what that looks like. For the Dollar Shave Club, I can't quite get it out of the package, but there you go. So you can see the Dollar Shave Club has a few more. They have the grooves on the inside, the grooves going down the inside instead of just straight across. So putting them side by side, you should be able to see the difference on that. Okay, so now when it comes down to it, I felt they both cut very good. However, I did feel, with final end results and everything, what did I do with these? So end result, I felt that the Harry razor cut a little bit closer to the skin than the Dollar Shave Club. I felt the Dollar Shave Club had a lot of products, but I really did not like getting 10, 20 emails a week talking about men's private part scrubs and lots of nasty things that they use. And I'm sure as a gimmick for young guys, it was probably something that their advertising team thought was a great idea. As a female, I didn't really care for it. I really didn't want to hear that. I just wanted a razor and I didn't need to know about scrubbing for certain areas. So that was a deterrent. But like I said, this one from Harry's definitely felt better and it cut better. All in all, I actually deleted my account through Dollar Shave Club. I couldn't keep up with it. It was costing me so much money, and I was replacing a razor every 4 to 6 days. That's just too much. Now, I still have it because I have some leftovers, and it's kind of like a backup or maybe travel, but it really was not worth it in the long run for the money that you're spending. The Harry's, I have bought more because I'm afraid of losing my membership with them, but honestly, it's a phenomenal razor. I can push it out several months if I need to. It lasts for a long time. Their blades are phenomenal. Like, I'm not getting paid by them. They're not any kind of affiliate or sponsor of anything, any way, shape, or form. It's just a good razor. This particular one that is on right now has been on for almost 2 months. I really think it's really worth the money that you're putting out. Now, if you take what I have spent on here, on this Harry's razor, and you go to the store, now I told you I just found a 20 pack, your savings for your Frugal tip is out of control. It is not even worth it to buy store-bought razors, regardless. Even if you find the flimsy cheap ones that are, well, they don't have them. I don't think you can even get them for 99 cents anymore, but maybe the worst of the worst that cut your skin, I think you can get them for $7 or $8 now. But it's just not worth it. They don't last long. You get a lot of nicks. They don't have good control. If your hands are slippery with soap or something, you're gonna have an issue. This razor here is such a money saver. I have now not bought razors in months. It's really worth it. So for Frugal Tip Volume 4, this is the route to go, folks. Harry's razor. Thanks for watching. Be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe.